force goes on in. Red light appearing. The first of seven. Set, ready to be dispatched. Off they go. Midnight Hour, first of them to jump with Ice Skate. And also commencing very quickly is Freedom of the Press. Much handier as Ella Fella comes over quickly after the break. Followed by Miss Voodoo, who's going to camp just in behind those. A length and a half, It's a Lance. Trapped three deep around the outside from Ginger Mac. Down on the inside, Powerful Force. A length and a half to Sheol's Dream. Then I Forgot the Rail. And out the back, three lengths behind them is Stroud. They gallop along the riverside of the track, putting the 900 behind them. Ella Fella had cruised to the lead now. Took over Ella Fella for Harvey and settled about a length in front. Running second, Freedom of the Press. Three quarters of a length away when the speed came off is Midnight Hour. It's a Lance around the outside with the white cap. Continues to quickly pick them up. Goes up in front of Ms. Voodoo. Followed then by Sheol's Dream. Following It's a Lance to the home turn. Ice Skate back on the inside of Ginger Mac. Now Pike's looking to come off the fence back there with Powerful Force with I Forgot. And still two lengths to Stroud. Nearing the home turn, they're about to balance up at the 350. Ella Fella joined by Freedom of the Press, and It's a Lance who's gone up, got its head in front. A length away, Sheol's Dream is starting to let down. Here comes Ginger Mac from back in the field as well. It's a Lance, now the baldy face. Ginger Mac sweeps up with 100 left to go and sprints to the lead. Powerful Forces finishing on well back behind those, but Ginger Mac comes away. Ginger Mac breaks his maiden status today, beat either It's a Lance or Powerful Force. Ella Fella battled away, Freedom of the Press, Sheol's Dream together, then Ms. Voodoo, followed by Ice Skate, Midnight Hour. I Forgot well back there, and Stroud trailed them right throughout the entire running of the race to finish back there stone motherless. Ginger Mac placed at 5 of 19 going into that contest today. Number one, Ginger Mac. Certainly had the best stats of any horse going around in race one. And although he settled back off the pace, tracked up well and has put them away to score his 20th run today off five minor placings previously for trainer Greg Cave. Beats It's a Lance. And a Powerful Force will be third home in front of Ella Fella, Sheol's Dream and Freedom of the Press. Ginger Mac saluting. Overdue, to say the least, by Gingerbread Man from Sharn, owned by Jane Buslinger, and prepared out at Orange Grove by Greg Cave. Troy Turner, the winning rider, scored by a length and a quarter. Six, It's a Lance, the Blackfriars three-year-old. Justin and Lucy Warwick teaming up his second home. And third is number eight, Powerful Force, by Redoute's Choice out of Avante, Grant and Lalana Williams and William Pike. The time is 1:26.57. Not very fast at all, suffice to say. And the sectional is 35.93. One and a quarter and a long neck. Certainly presented terrific by Greg Cave. Big distinctive white blaze and plenty of horse, that's for sure, underneath of Troy Turner, and gets the job done this afternoon. As we head over and take a look at race number two, the next at 2:19, the Tab Touch Maiden over the 1500, where there are no changes. Let's go downstairs. Brittany joining us, and a good win, overdue too, by Ginger Mac, who had been placed on numerous occasions going into that event.
I think overdue is the right word, Darren. Greg Cave joins me now. Greg, I heard you walk into the yard and say, gee, it's been a frustrating horse. And I guess that what happens when they're a 19 start maiden? Why was today the day?
I don't know. He just, like you say, he's frustrated. I've been pulling my ear out trying to get him to win one. And I think half the time, half his problem is he might be camera shy.
He didn't mind the camera today, though.
No, that's good, because he was on the outside, so he couldn't see it. But anyway, he's been working good and done everything right. And even Troy said, it's a nice race for him today. And after his last start, we thought he'd be a big chance, as long as he pulled up good, which he has. And we'll just press on from here and see where we go now.
You mentioned Troy had a degree of confidence coming into the race. Where did he think map-wise he would be? And did it eventuate just as you had hoped?
Yeah, well, he's always gets back and finishes off, which just seems to suit him. So we always thought we'd be back in midfield somewhere and just stay off the fence. And, have one crack at them. That's his best way of running him.
He's taken a little while. Has he been a horse that you've seen develop and mature along the way?
No.
At least you're honest.
Yeah. No, he's just him. He's just, he's a nice horse in that, but He makes you think all the time. Yeah. When you think you got the better of him, he'll do something else. So.
Hey, well, today you've got the job done, so well done.
Thank you.
Greg Cave there after the victory of Ginger Mac. And clearly a horse that now at 5 years old, he's taken a long time to put his head in front when it counts. But five placings along the way, he's a consistent performer and he's been consistent throughout his most recent runs, a third back in January. Only a fortnight ago, finishing third there and able to go a couple better today, Scott.
I remember backing this horse on debut, Britt, and it's been a long, long time ago now. I think that was back in the Jane Buslinger days, and Renee Forrest may have even ridden that day, but looked to show a little bit at trials, and that's admittedly a long time ago now, but looked to be a really, really good race for him today coming out of that form race behind Fiery Bay, Britt, because those horses here were just... Look, they were very well specced in the market. We had Troy Turner, who was on Ginger Mac and was heavily supported. And we also had down the bottom Miss Voodoo, who was out of that same race that was heavily supported. So the market was spot on with the fact that the best form line there was the one behind Fiery Bay. Sean O'Donnell, we got Troy Turner. I'm just getting confused, and so were you with that little bit of missing gear.
Yeah, dropped me gel pedal, come in a kilo light.
We didn't want that. This is a pretty good market move that's landed here. Troy, now talk to us about this horse. Greg was saying it's just been a matter of waiting to try and find eventually the right race.
Yeah, early days he was probably doing things wrong, and Greg's got him going pretty well now. His run suggests he would be right in the market today, so it was good to get him across the line.
I looked and watched you in the run. It looked like you were keen to try and join that three wide train at some stage.
Yeah, they weren't going anywhere on the inside there, so... When the rail's out, sometimes it's best to sort of get swooping on them.
It's a tough little question to ask, but do you think you can go on and win a class one now?
I think so, yeah.
What about Frosty Bell, your next ride in the race number three? What sort of chance do you give her?
Yeah, I think she feels like she will appreciate the 1800. So I'd give her a really good chance.
Congratulations. Good luck, Jagsy.
Thank you.
I think she's an each-way price too, so not a bad push there. But he's on the board, Troy Turner, with Ginger Mac, start number 20, and he finally breaks through, this son of Gingerbread Man, for Greg Cave, taking out the Amelia Park Lodge Maiden.
Cold, I roll my eyes at you, boy. I'm a cool.